We talk a lot about routines, and now we're going to talk about how to jumpstart your brain, morning routine, evening routines, because, I mean, really, the success that everyone is desiring, it's hidden in our daily habits, right? First, you create your habits, and then your habits create you. But one of the things that a bad habit, the most successful people, they have their to-do list, and we all have our to-do list. But I've also noticed that some of the highest achievers, they have a not-to-do list. You know what I mean? They have a list of non-negotiable things they will not indulge in because, you know, we've all read the book Good to Great. You say no to good so you can say yes to great, right? And a lot of times when you get more and more successful, you suffer from this opportunity stress, right? You get more and more offers, more and more opportunity, and you can't say yes to everything. And that's a big challenge because then you have so many windows open on your computer. And even if they're minimized, they still take up energy and they still take up space and memory. And you wonder why you're fatigued all the time. You wonder why you don't have the mental energy to do the things that you need to be able to do. So digital distraction, and on the top of your not-to-do list should be not checking your phone in the first thing in the morning. And I know everyone's listening to me, and automatically so many people are just like, oh my God, you know, like I hate this guy. But the first hour of the day, the reason why you don't want to pick up your phone is because, and we're all guilty of this, is because it rewires your brain for two things. Number one, it rewires your brain for distraction. When you wake up first thing in the morning, you're in this relaxed, alpha, creative, very suggestible state, right? You just woke up. And so you have to be very careful and protect and stand guard to your mind from outside influences. Because number one, if the first thing you see on your phone, you're watching these cat videos and, you know, everything that's going on social media, you're getting this dopamine flood, which is building your distraction muscles. Because when it comes to focus is like, there's a focus fitness, if you will, and you have focus muscles, but you also have distraction muscles. And a lot of people, their distraction muscles are way overdeveloped because of picking the phone up first thing in the morning. But the second reason, for a neurological reason, why you don't want to pick up your phone the first hour of the day is because it also rewires your brain for reaction. It's training your brain to be reactive. And so, you know, as you know, you go through your phone, you wake up in the morning, you pick up your phone, you get one text, one voicemail message, one, you know, email, and all of a sudden your day is shot. Mm-hmm. Like it puts you in a bad mood, and you carry that mood throughout your entire day. And that's a big challenge because, you know, if you're just fighting fires, then you're just on the defense. If you're just trying to fulfill everyone else's needs without going through like what's going to help me to win this day, to own this, you know, this day, to be able to make it the best, then you're reacting. And I have a friend, Brendan Burchard. He says, your inbox is nothing but a convenient organizational system for other people's agenda for your life. I mean, you guys know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So you're training your brain to react, and you can never have an incredible day if you're just reacting to things, right? So for me, I wake up in the morning and what I just start journaling, and I write down three things I want to accomplish personally that day and three things I want to accomplish professionally. And it's different every single day, but I always begin with the end in mind. One of my favorite books of all time is this book called 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Mm-hmm. And we've read this book. Some people are like, I have that book and it's sitting on my shelf. And it becomes shelf help, not self-help, right? Because nobody's actually like reading that book. Because so many people buy books, and I like to encourage people to read at least one book a week, because the average person reads about 2, maybe 3 books a year. But what I love about reading, number one, is the best exercise, you know, for your mind. And, you know, it's like reading is to your mind what exercise is to your body. It's an incredible workout. And but most people, they don't take the time to read. But the other reason I like to read is if somebody has decades of experience in leadership, negotiation, entrepreneurship, fitness, and they put it into a book, and you could sit down in a couple of days and read that book, you could download decades of experience into days. And that's a huge advantage, right? Because leaders are readers. So when I'm writing what I need to accomplish, I'm writing 3 personal things, 3 professional things. But this book, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, one of the habits of highly effective people is actually put first things first. Put first things first. Meaning, I believe that the most important thing is to keep the most important thing the most important thing. The most important thing is to keep the most important thing the most important thing. Because a lot of people have a fear of a failure or fear of success. You know, my fear has always been, I don't want to succeed at things that don't matter. It wasn't so much about failing, it's about getting really good at something that didn't make a difference. And Stephen Covey talks about it like you're really good at climbing the ladder of success only to get to the top and realize that it's leaning on the wrong wall. And so if you begin with the end in mind, so I'm thinking about my friend Clay Bear has this phrase about champagne moments. You know, in sports, it's very clear when you're popping that champagne, what has to happen, your criteria. And for me, I think about if I'm coming back, you know, at night and somebody asked me how my day was and I was like, I crushed it today. You know, what had to happen working backwards in order for that to happen? And I think about three things professionally, three things personally. And so I write that down first thing in the morning and then I don't check my phone until I get one of those checks done. Just at least one thing, you know, and then I get some positive momentum, for example. But that's the reason you don't want to check your phone. It's training you to be distracted and it's rewiring your brain to be reactive. And you can't be successful and fulfilled if you're just giving up the sovereignty, your power to something outside of yourself.